Good morning. Thanks for waking up with us here on Good Morning Malibu. Grab yourself a cup of coffee and stay tuned. We have a great show for you.
Stay with us. Good morning, Malibu. I'm Shayla Girardin.
And I'm Thoriola. Thanks again for joining us here on Good Morning Malibu. We hope you enjoyed your first day of spring yesterday.
Bright and early.
Bright and early. Shayla mentioned that I dressed like spring today.
Yes, so you're color coordinated and everything.
Welcoming in the season you.
Yes, our first spring Good Morning Malibu, yes. So welcome.
So today is the second day of spring. It's also Twitter's birthday. Twitter turns 8 today. The social media network has a gift for its users. The microblogging site has launched a first tweet tool to show everyone's first tweet. So you can go on this tool, type in anyone's handle, and see what their first tweet is. Twitter's promoting the first anniversary with hashtag first tweet. You can search and then retweet. We have some fun celebrity first tweets for you. Britney Spears said, "Welcome Britney Spears to Twitter, or welcome Britney Spears fans to Twitter. Follow the latest in Britney news and get updates straight from Britney and her entourage." It's funny that Britney's first tweet ever wasn't even from Britney.
Britney's staff. Bless her heart.
Shayla is so distraught. Conan O'Brien.
I have faith in her.
I know. She couldn't even tweet. That may have been the time when she hit her little Britney rough patch. So
probably. That might have been the bald head.
Yeah, the bald head phase on Britney's Twitter. Conan O'Brien said, "Today I interviewed a squirrel in my backyard and then threw to a commercial, 'Somebody help me.' I interviewed a squirrel at Gladstone's the other night." And
why don't we interview
too.
Any squirrels on Good Morning Malibu next week?
Next week.
Next week.
And then we'll tell Conan O'Brien about it. Nikki Polizzi, Snooki, said her first tweet was, "IDK WTF I am doing," which turned into her life motto. And the only word that she spelled out in the entire tweet was doing. Everything else was abbreviated. And then she couldn't even do an ellipsis properly. She put dot, dot. She didn't even put three dots. So spot on there, Snooki or Snooki.
We can overlook that one. It's Twitter. I feel like there's some freedom with grammar and correct grammar on Twitter, right?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to give Snooki the benefit of the doubt on that one.
I won't. Shayla will. Pros and cons. Martha Stewart, her first tweet was using Twitter for the first time, exclamation point. I was joking. I thought it would be get me out, exclamation point.
That one came a little later.
It came a little later. And Justin Bieber's first tweet, which is just hysterical, was check out my single one time on my MySpace and spread the word for me, myspace.com/Justin Bieber, which he had a MySpace. He tweeted about his MySpace.
Way back in the day. Yeah. Oh my goodness. I don't even want to know what my first tweet was. I'm sure back in high school days. But speaking of other apps that are coming out, now UNICEF is releasing a brand new app. So now for every minute you refrain from using your phone, you can actually raise money for clean water. In honor of World Water Day, UNICEF is launching a new app. And for every minute a user refrains from touching their cell phone, they will unlock a small portion of donations. And for every 10 minutes, donors will fund a whole day of clean water. And total funds raised from the campaign are actually going to be used for water, sanitation, and hygiene programs in countries with the most need. And this is so cool because there are so many random apps, as we've noticed, especially over the past
couple
weeks.
Shayla and I have a tendency to
Good Morning
read
Malibu.
About and talk about apps.
There's an abundance.
There are quite a lot of them. I'm not sure, though, that all the other app developers aren't necessarily happy with this app, because it's basically saying don't use all the other apps
don't
and we'll reward you for
phone.
It.
Don't use your cell phone. I don't know how I'm going to do with this one. Cause
I will do horribly. I check my
I like
phone
to
every
use
5
my
seconds.
Phone. Yeah.
Yes. Shayla has a Barbie phone.
That is true. But if I can abstain for just a couple minutes, I'll be helping a good cause. So wish me luck. It's a work in progress.
If you haven't checked your Pepperdine email in the past 2 days, you're missing the Pepperdine Fishing. Pepperdine Student Activities is organizing the first annual Pepperdine Fish. Students can head down to alumni this weekend and fish out of the freshly stocked alumni pond, I think. No, that was wrong. Pepperdine Phishing, it was an email that was sent out by Pepperdine IT, Information Technology. They sent out a fake scam email to students to teach them about phishing scams and scam emails. The email was sent by a fake Pepperdine email that ended in .net instead of .edu to try and fool students. The email said that a sensitive document was waiting for your signature and then asked you to log on with your username and your password to claim it. The IT center then sent out a nasty message about monitoring your email more closely and not divulging your personal information and passwords. So Shayla and I were talking about this. I have two kind of small issues with this. The first one was I've never received a scam email on my Pepperdine email, so
yeah,
I wasn't really expecting
one.
I only use my Pepperdine email to email Pepperdine students and faculty. I don't give it out. And then the other thing was the link that you click on directed you to WaveNet. It was legitimately WaveNet.
It took you to a Pepperdine source. It totally fooled me.
Yeah, so
if it
was a scam email, it really wouldn't send you to WaveNet. So I was like, oh, it's WaveNet. Why? I mean, so I just typed in my WaveNet password. But, you know, it is a good thing that the IT brought this to everyone's attention. The way they did it may have been a little interesting.
Yeah.
But, you know, it is a big problem, especially with personal email accounts. I think it's more prevalent with
Absolutely.
Our Gmail accounts or our Hotmail accounts than with our Pepperdine emails because, you know, I do get a lot of spam email, and I know a lot of people do because you give out your email to stores and companies, and that is a big problem. So it's nice that they brought this to our attention, and I think it's making a lot of students think about their emails a little bit more, but it is kind of a comical way.
It is a comical way. And it was Pepperdine, of course, that put out the scam email.
Yeah.
So, of course, they would be good at duplicating themselves.
Yeah.
But, oh well, it fooled me. That's probably why I'm bitter.
Yeah.
And on a separate note, Fortune magazine just released a list of the world's 50 greatest leaders. Pope Francis topped the list for his work in the Catholic Church and was followed closely by actress Angelina Jolie and former President Bill Clinton. But noticeably absent from the list was President Obama. YouTube frontmen and the CEOs of YouTube, Apple, and Ford also made the list, but no President Obama. So Angelina Jolie's there.
I am pumped
all the
that Angie's up there. I am pumped.
Angie is high up on the list.
Angie and the Popes, my two favorite things.
Angie
Catholics
and the Pope
and
representing.
Angie.
And but no President Obama, so
I know it's interesting.
I'm sorry, Obama.
When they do lists like that and when they compile all the data and
yeah.
pick people, you know, they always have reasons for it. So
it
I'm
is.
Interested
and
to
I
see.
Wonder exactly what the qualifications yeah. are because it is such a mixed list and
yes.
there's so much variety there
yes.
that you wonder who exactly made those final calls.
And they pulled from so many different areas,
yeah.
like social and political and business, and it's
Absolutely.
Interesting how they balanced all of it.
Athletes, actors and actresses, quite a variety.
Yeah. We're going to take a quick break. When we get back, though, we'll be back with the latest news and your weather and sports from
and
Pepperdine and around the world.
Interview.
And a very special interview. So stay tuned here on Good Morning Malibu.